had a strong and a confident and a vigilant America stands ready tonight to defend an honored cause, whatever the price, whatever the burden, whatever the sacrifice that duty may require.
February of 1965, President Johnson ordered continuous bombing of North Vietnam in retaliation for the numerous North Vietnamese attacks on U.S. installations. Aircraft like these B-52 bombers could carry as much as 30 tons of explosives. Flying in groups of threes, they would depart from a U.S. Air Force base in Bangkok, Thailand, to drop 90 tons of explosives on North Vietnam. By October of 1965, there were over 100,000 U.S. American troops in Vietnam, with U.S. Marines doing most of the fighting. The U.S. Navy was responsible for providing tactical air support for the South Vietnamese Army. United States Marines were among the first U.S. troops to land on Cam Ray Bay in South Vietnam. By 1966, over 200,000 American soldiers were in Vietnam. In the South, the military strategy has shifted from that of pacification to that of search and destroy. The combined action platoon consisted of 38 South Vietnamese soldiers combined with a U.S. Marine rifle squad. Thank you. As the confidence of the North Vietnamese Army grew, guerrilla tactics gave way to major offensives. Horrors of war have now become a daily reality for the South Vietnamese. The number of displaced and homeless had become staggering. For many of the children, war became their only teacher. conflict that was expected to last no more than a year had now extended into its third. U.S. firepower continued to exact its toll on the North Vietnamese. In February 1968, the Communists launched a Tet Offensive, attacking almost every major capital city in South Vietnam. Once again, the people of South Vietnam were the real losers. troops at the Marine Air Base at Khe Sanh began preparing for an attack they knew would come. Meanwhile, further south in Saigon, not only the city but the U.S. Embassy was under siege by the North Vietnamese. Although the attack on Saigon was unsuccessful, the toll on the civilian population was immense. Quê, one of the oldest cities in South Vietnam, was not spared and fell victim to the North Vietnamese. The U.S. Marines were called upon to retake the city. Although suffering heavy casualties, they decisively defeated the North Vietnamese army.